Welcome, Civ fans, to the developer video for the final pack in the Civilization VI New Frontier Pass.
We'll be announcing our next new Civ and giving you all the details on two new world wonders, a new map script, and another exciting brand new game mode.
Every time we've announced any new Civ, we've seen a ton of requests on social media for this Civ. It's been so hard to keep it secret when there's been so much demand for it, but finally, at long last, we are thrilled to announce that the next new Civ is... known for its vast naval empire, powerful port cities, being one of the first truly global civilizations. At long last, we're bringing you Portugal.
We'll be saving a detailed discussion of Portugal's mechanics for the first look video, but it should come as no surprise that you're going to need to sharpen your naval skills.
History has so many compelling civilizations, it's always a challenge for us to choose which one we want to feature next. However, Portugal gave us the chance to design some systems that really encourage and reward maritime exploration and trade. This is something that not a lot of other civs specialize in, so putting Portugal on a map really creates some fun strategic opportunities. We also used Portugal as the inspiration for one of our two world wonders, with the second hailing from another previously released civ, Babylon.
Historically, the imposing Torre de Belém served as a ceremonial gateway to Lisbon. In Civilization VI, it grants additional gold and great admiral points. It also provides bonus gold for every luxury resource at a destination of international trade routes. And when constructed, gives any city you own on another continent a free building. Meanwhile, the towering ziggurat at Temenanki grants additional science yields every turn, as well as bonus science and production to all floodplains in its home city, and marsh tiles in its civilization.
Speaking of marsh tiles, the Portugal pack also includes a new map script, the Wetlands. Dominated by marshes, this map offers new strategic challenges and defensive possibilities. For example, while marshes penalize movement, careful positioning can allow ranged units to exploit enemies' reduced speed.
Finally, the bone mint we've been waiting for, included in the Portugal pack, is our latest brainchild.
Zombie defense. In this optional grave mode, the dead don't stay dead for long and present an ever-growing threat to the world's civilizations. Or as I like to think of it, an ever-growing brain drain.
In zombie defense, every unit slain in combat has a chance to rise from the battlefield as a ravenous zombie. Zombie units chase and attack the nearest non-zombie unit, and any unit they successfully catch, crunch, and kill respawns as zombies themselves.
But don't worry, because sadly, the living can fight back. An arsenal of new trap and barricade improvements deal damage to hostile units that pass through or near them. These mode-specific improvements can be built on owned or neutral territory. And again, sadly, zombies' obsession with brain banquets and digestive devastation means they can only fall victim to the traps and barricades and are unable to pillage them. Huh?
Also, unluckily for the undead, two new city projects allow civilizations to temporarily subjugate the zombie units within a city's limit, putting them under players' control. This lets you direct zombies' mindless mayhem at your opponent. You can either use zombies to directly target enemy units, or just move them out of your city and closer to someone else's brains.
Delicious.
You'll also have access to the Zombie Defense Spy Operation, which attempts to spawn zombie units on work tiles in another player's city.
And most importantly, brains!
To sum up, the sixth and final installment of the New Frontier Pass is the much-requested Portugal pack. Also featuring new world wonders from Portugal and Babylon, a new marsh-focused map script, and a new game mode that my coworkers are really, really hyped about.
Civ fans, you're the best fans in gaming. We appreciate your support through every New Frontier Pass pack release, and we hope you'll continue to follow us on social media to keep up to date on all the latest in the Civilization franchise. For one thing, be sure to check back in April as we reveal the final free game update of the season.
We hope you are all staying safe and healthy and non-zombified. And remember, when it comes to Civilization or the undead, there's always one more
brain
turn. The hashtag is one more turn.